Hey, good evening guys, I'm Shashank Sharma. Today I'm in Cappadocia. Right now it's 5 o'clock and I'm starting this Cappadocia tour. This is really not a good time to start. Actually I went for a sleep as I did the overnight journey from Antalya to Cappadocia. Now I'm just heading out, looking for some food or maybe something to do. The first impression of the city is absolutely mind-blowing. This city is so raw, so finished, and it looks so beautiful. I can't even explain in words. Everywhere you can see the lights, the very dim lights, and everything is crafted here in a very beautiful manner. All the restaurants are very romantic. The whole city is surrounded by the stone mountains, and the scenic view from every single point is out of the world. I can't believe that I'm really in here. Now I'm feeling bad that I just planned it here for 2 days. If someone is coming here, you probably spend 3, 4, 5 nights. Never withdraw the money from this ATM. This one is charging $10 to withdraw 1,000 lira plus 6% as a market fee. So really not a good option. This bank didn't tell me how much they are gonna charge for the cash withdrawal, but they are just giving me the money without even telling me. And this Deniz Bank was charging 30 lira plus currency conversion markup fee. And this one didn't charge anything. The bank says there will be no markup fee, but in total they withdraw 12,700 and something. Actual price should be 12,250. They charge 500 rupees extra for 1,000 lira or for 12,000 Indian rupee. So I prefer that you take the credit cards, because whenever I'm using my credit card, I am just getting charged for 12 rupee plus the currency conversion markup fee. In total, I'm paying 12.25 is the max. Whether you're trying it with the Kodak or with the SBI. This is the most shittiest water booth I have ever seen. Look at this. what they click, and they didn't put anything in the background or anywhere.
Yeah.
for the vegetarian pie. So they put the mushroom, tomatoes, and some chilies, the green chilies, which I'm going to remove it. And along with this, this is an orange tea. Yes, orange tea. The flavor of this tea is, I cannot even explain. Every sip of tea is giving immense amount of flavors of orange. It is so perfect. The amount of cheese in all these pies are totally crazy. I can't eat that much cheese. Oh my god, I'm still eating it. The taste of the cheese is really good. I was really not hungry, but the craving to have a wonderful pie took me to this restaurant. I really like to recommend everyone who like to have this Turkish pide. That was really fantastic. Whether you are going for the fine dining or for on the street food, the price is almost 20, 25, 15, not more than that, not less than that. This restaurant charged me 20 plus 5 for the orange tea. That was really good, so highly recommended. There are a few things I like to highlight about this city. One is that everyone is talking about the balloon ride and the tours and the thing which every tourist wants to do. People are just busy in taking trips and coming back, and they are going back to the hotel, sleeping and again preparing it for the next day. But I guess you should take a walk here on the streets, because people are here are friendly, and you can see a lot of cosmopolitan culture as well. People from almost all the nations are roaming around, and you have a lot of things to eat. There are fancy restaurants, there are fine dining restaurants, and there are also a few street food you can try. In the evening time it's freezing cold, but still people are love to walk here. Last night I walked for almost around 2-3 hours here, and then I went for that dinner. But right now even I have no plans now so far, but even if I'll do something before that or after that, I'm definitely gonna take a walk. I'm really loving the ambience here, especially these small stones, mountains which are lying in between of the streets, and from every part of the city you can see them. That's something which I really like it here in Cappadocia. Also, there are a lot of rooftop restaurants here with a viewpoint, like that one, if you can see. They are pretty good for dining experience, and you can see the entire city from there. Probably I'm gonna eat at some of that places. Thank you. generally it tastes very good, but here I didn't like it. It was so-so. Anyways, the view is outstanding. From here you can see the entire city. Don't keep expectations that if you're coming to Turkey then you can shoot something. The people will allow you in their shop for free to do their shooting and everything. It's actually not free. There's a heavy price on this. So, hey, good morning guys. This is going to be the breakfast for today. I ordered the pie with not with the cheese, with the hummus and the tomato and mushroom, along with orange tea. I stayed in cave hotels for almost 3 nights, and I really liked the experience. If I'll come next time, I'm also gonna stay in the cave hotel once again. And it really doesn't matter whether you're choosing the 3-star, 4-star or 5-star. All the amenities and everything is gonna be the same, I guess. I didn't stay in the 4-star, but I stayed in the 3-star one. And generally people say that there are only difference in the number of caves, means like number of rooms, if you are comparing one with the amenities. And sometimes they have beautiful paintings, hangings, that's it. There is no big difference in 3 or 4 at least. I must say that this is one of the beautiful places that everyone should visit at least once in their life. And I really missed the balloon flight today as well, because there is a snowfall every day in the morning time, so all the flights are getting cancelled. And like the balloon flights I'm talking about, if you're coming here, try to come here for at least for 4 days, because you're not gonna see everything in 1 or 2 days. For me, 3 days are not enough. Trust me, 3 days are literally not enough. I really wanted to have the balloon flight, but anyways, just in case if you're coming here and planning to take your own car, then feel free to pick it up, rent a car, or maybe any other company, whichever you like, because they have plenty of parking spaces everywhere. In the market, in the hotels, and all the attractions for the travelers have the parking space, enough parking space for everyone. So go for it, you're gonna love this road trips here. And let's end this vlog of Cappadocia here.